Alrighty, good evening everybody, and you are here, salute you whenever you are. So, those are the famous Team Andro pictures that are by far the best in the business. Team Andro is an overachieving German bodybuilding slash fitness outlet, and there is a guy named Matthias Busse, who I do salute properly. Now, although Big Ramy did not win in Spain, which is the contest of these pictures that I'm showing right here, he was very good. I think it was the best shape of his life, right? That show was won by Dexter Jackson, but I think a week later, Big Ramy won in Kuwait, and they were quite close, to be honest. Both of them were good in both contests. They could have shuffled either or, it would have been just fine. And I deemed, and everybody actually agrees, that these pictures or the shape of Big Ramy was the best of his life ever. To be noted, to put you in contest, this is Spain, as I mentioned, which is pretty much right after Miss Olympia. That is the European tour, right? So they went there. They went to Prague, as far as I know. They went to Kuwait, as I mentioned, Spain, and so on and so forth. Sorry for my dishwasher, but it is timely, isn't it? So, it was pretty much damage control when it comes to Big Ramy, because he messed up in Mr. Olympia. If you guys recall, I was pretty much following that live with you, and I called him Medium Ramy. Medium Ramy. To not say Mediocre Ramy. He was not saluted by no means. It was a disappointment. And lately, I've seen like the prep pictures, which were published, incidentally, by Badr Budai. You know what? Let's take a look at him, since we're here. Why not? Why not? Now, Badr Budai is playing some mind games lately. So this is the picture of Big Ramy last year. Forgive me, it is small, but you get the idea. Look at him. This was last year in his Mr. Olympia prep. Look how small he was. Does he really deserve the name Big Ramy back then? Absolutely not. He was absolutely melted down, malnourished, in a quest of bringing him very diced. What happened is he melted completely. The muscle mass, the freakiness that is supposed to be his card, was gone. It was not saluted at all, right? I remind you, this was 2016 prep. Well, the last picture that were leaked to the public were pretty much these ones here. Wow, of course he looks bigger, definitely, but this was a while back, right? So this was on August the 7th. Right now we're August the 28th, so 3 weeks ago. And why am I rambling about this? Why am I rambling about this? So allow me to bring you back to actually my social media. Because yours truly, I'm really grateful for that. You know, I received exclusive pictures from Big Ramy, right? This morning, sent to me, of course, by Badr Budai, his trainer. It was first thing in the morning. Better to know that Kuwait is not the same timeline as North American Eastern Coast. So I shut off my Wi-Fi. I know I wake up, I receive tons of messages on WhatsApp, on Instagram, and so on and so forth. I didn't eat. I was barely awake, right? I took a look at him, and I was like, no, what is this sight? What am I looking at right now? And I kid you not. And again, you guys know me since a while. I'm trying to weigh my words when I'm saying this. Big Ramy. And take your time to listen to me, right? Big Ramy absolutely, as I see him this morning, overshadows this so-called shape of Team Andro of Spain by a long, long shot. And I mean a long shot in every single pose, every single muscle group. The legs, which were already magnificent, absolutely have been upgraded. The size of the guy, and well, allow me to, if we can see the back, you know, this back right here, it's not the same. It absolutely has been upgraded. The lower back is better. The shadow game, the size of the gentleman is absolutely stupendous. And I didn't show, you know what? I mean, Badr Budai knows me. If it is bad, I'm gonna tell him it's bad. I didn't sugarcoat it. I mean, I was honest with him. Big Ramy is looking better than ever. The hamstring sweep has nothing to do with this. As a matter of fact, here it was not there. It was a weakness last year. The hammies were not saluted. The back was kind of erased in a sense. Absolutely not proper. Definitely way better, leaps and bounds. So this is what I can tell you. And of course, it is just words as we speak. But then again, you need to comprehend. Nobody is leaking nothing. Do you know a top guy's leaking pictures? It is that prerogative, and everybody has obviously to respect that. As a matter of fact, the pictures of Vigrami I saw this morning were not taken in the usual, you know, that Kuwait anabolic mirror. No, like when you see Rolly Winkler and the rest of the guys. No, I mean he is so secretive. His trainer, I mean, it was taken in a bathroom, probably first thing in the morning. And yes, I had to be honest. I mean, I compared the picture. I put them on my phone side by side, front double biceps, back double biceps, the shadow game, and the size of the gentleman. Again, the size. It is almost insulting. It is crazy. It is definitely extreme. So there you have it, guys. I have to convey this to you. And listen up. If he carries that shape and he surfs on it till Mr. Olympia, you guys will say, wow, and that's it. And is it good news? I don't know. Is it bad news for bodybuilding? I don't know. Because if big orexia guys try to follow suit of Big Ramy, good freaking luck. You will never reach this. Listen, this is the back actually. Let me try to make it bigger actually. It was mediocre. It was not good. This back right here cannot beat Phil Heath. This back cannot beat Phil Heath. Forget about it. Again, HD picture by Matthias Busse, my German sauerkraut eating photographer. I salute you. But this back right here, compared to what I saw this morning, it's totally different beast. It's not the same. You got ridges here. You got some shadow name attracting the light and keeping it. The lower back, dude did some deadlifts. He definitely did that. The size, the separation. I put the biceps next to his biceps and I laughed. That's why I posted the picture, because I was putting them one next to each other, and the difference is rather already staggering. It is what it is. So there you have it. Will he keep it? I really hope so. It's gonna be eventful. It's gonna be something historical. Again, you need to comprehend that over here, and that's oversized Mr. Busse. Over here, it was pretty much damage control, coming back from Mr. Olympia, putting up some carbs, trying to pump up this body. But as I said, it was just trying to stitch the thing. And it was enough to beat Dexter Jackson, Sean Roden, Bonac, and so on, and to be compared to the best. But let's be honest, this shape was not enough to box with Phil Heath. However, listen, and it's not one picture. If what I saw this morning steps next to the version of 2016, it is a game. I tell you, it is the game, even from the back. And that's it. So time will tell, but Big Ramy is utterly surprising. And as a testament, before closing this Big Ramy chapter right here, there is another guy who is his teammate, obviously, working from Kuwait. Now, this is Brandon Curry, right? Pretty much, let's be honest, the most eventful bodybuilder of 2017, which was a dead season. He came from the dead and he saved the day in Australia and actually sort of in New Zealand, right? Versus the late Dallas. Of course, we all remember that. Now look at him. This picture was taken yesterday and he's already quite heavier compared to that version of the Kiwi show, right? It is a testament. He's looking proper. I showed you also the picture of their training partner, Mr. Nathan D'Asha, freaking Seth Feroci. When he saw him, he was like, what the hell? Granite all day and every day. And better to know, now, these guys from there, most of them do not carry a bubble, trouble, triple gut bonanza. It plays. You can't hide a triple gut bonanza in the front double biceps if you do have it a lot. I'm sorry, it shows, right? You will not see it in Big Ramy, you will not see it in Brandon Curry and the guys from there, right? And of course, there are certain triggering things we cannot speak about nowadays on YouTube, right? But there are some technicalities behind the scene that cause those kind of bubble gut bonanza that these guys do not believe in down there, right? It makes a difference, right? I mean, go ahead and take a look at Brandon Curry last year, right? I tell you what, he was taking creatine, he was not natural, but it has nothing to do with the body that he has nowadays. Looks better, cleaner. It is that's difference, that you know, percentage of cleanliness in a sense, because no heavy metals, you know what I mean, no hot tubs and so on and so forth. So that's that. So I'll salute you wherever you are. I really wanted to convey this message. This is all we can leak. I have no information from Dexter Jackson. Of course, no information from the reigning Mr. Olympia Phil Heath. I think he decided to do some kind of partnership with some TV service or some video streaming service. I have no idea. I don't know. You tell me if you're following that. I'm not. So that's that. Salute you whatever you are. Hey, I didn't know I was a millionaire. Let me aware you. If you guys didn't know, let me drop the sound so you can comprehend.
You know what I mean? You got like, you know, this guy Louis Marco making millions of dollars off of, you know, because he could talk a daily, you know, about everybody else. I'm not ranking him down, but come on, be realistic, you know? It's the internet's changed bodybuilding.
My gains are oil. Salute you, whatever you are. And again, allow me to share with you some progress of my trainees. Baby, please. This guy, his name is Juan Ponce. I will tag him later. We started 210. He dropped to 171. Of course, he's not out of the oven as of yet. I need to work on this some more weeks. Definitely at least 8 weeks, to be honest with you guys. It's not easy. I mean, Rome was not built in a day. So this guy needs at least another 8 weeks of good and rigorous job. You guys already know the other guy. He lost 55 pounds so far. He sent me the last message like a few hours ago, and I smiled, really smiled, because he's exactly at 200. We started at 255. His name is Corey C. the Great. He is a bike driver, mind you, so right now he's even faster because the weight to power ratio is definitely positive now on his bike. We're not done yet. We're going to bounce back when he reaches 195. It's going to be a proper carb up. He's a sight to be seen and very diligent, very serious. This guy sent me pictures and videos of him doing cardio. He is to be saluted. So if you guys are interested by training of Louis Marco, the address is simple. It is here. Look at it. Louis Marco training at gmail.com. I answer all the emails, of course. Natties, baby, please. No enhanced bodies. Salute you wherever you are. Don't forget to like the video and tell me what you guys think about it.